What was that scramble? Hello everyone and welcome to Zebra Cubes. In this video, we're going to be going over one of the most obscure solves in cubing history, Drew Brad's unofficial 3.72 second single. So let's get into this. So here I have the scramble right now and on the screen in case you want to follow. And the first thing we're going to do is we're going to convert this stickerless cube into a stickered cube, because back then, stickered cubes were more popular and stickerless cubes were banned in competitions. So, okay, so what he first did is he started off the solve by facing blue and with white on top and yellow on bottom, as he did a yellow cross. We could see he could get a free triple X cross. That's right. Not a free X cross, not a free double X cross like most of Timon's solves, a free triple X cross. The way he did it is he looked at this corner and edge pair and he wanted to solve it without disrupting its correct edge, which is right here. And the way he did that was he did a U prime L U F, followed by a wide U prime. The next thing he did was he did a wide D move so that way his last F2L pair would be in the front, which is typically good. The way he solved that was by doing an L, U2, L, U2, and then the standard insert. Now he has this OLL and he solves it using this algorithm, which is the same algorithm that I use. Let's consider the fact that at the time, the official world record single was held by Mats Valk with a time of 5.55 seconds. Mom. Had Drew gotten this time officially, it wouldn't be until November 24th of 2018, basically 4 years later, and it would have been broken by Yu Sheng Du with his 3.47 second solve. Now, Drew stated that he didn't count this as his PB because it was only 23 moves. And typically, any Rubik's Cube scramble can be solved in 20 moves or less. That lucky scramble gave Drew a very fast time because it had a low move count. The fewer amount of moves that it takes to solve a scramble, in theory, the faster the time will be. Now, this scramble is infamous for being called fake by many, and I mean many non-cubers. Cubers like myself believe that Drew actually got this time, as he was a world-class cuber at the time, and this scramble is very lucky. Typically, whenever world-class cubers encounter lucky scrambles, they'll get a good time. Look at Felix, Yihang, Timon, Max, Luke, the list goes on. Non-cubers didn't believe it because this solve, well, it was a very big jump from the world record at the time. What I'm more concerned about with this solve is what happened after Drew hit the space bar. What? I'm pretty sure his cube wasn't hurt after that stop, but man, that was one loud of a noise. I wonder what he did. Now, I'm gonna assume what he did is he stopped the timer and then clapped his hands, which is something that Max Park does a lot whenever he gets a good time. So you saw me at the beginning of the video do a down solve of this time, but that was with the stickerless cube. So now I'm giving it a shot with the stickered cube, just like how Drew did it. Okay, okay. Huh. Pretty fast. Okay, let's try down solving it again. See if I could go faster this time. Oh ho ho! Former world record. Yes! Haha. 388. So, what can I, as a cuber, learn from this scramble in order to improve my times? Well, what you should try to apply is, first off, using your inspection wisely and planning out as much as you can. As we could see, Drew managed to plan out a whole triple X cross, and most likely the fourth and final pair. Now, another thing that we could learn from this scramble is to improve our recognition and make it faster. As Drew quickly recognized this OLL case and solved it. Now, if you have much slower recognition, I'd recommend improving it more by using ALG trainers such as jperm.net. But that was it for this video. Thank you all so much for watching. Comment, like, and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye!